A leader in sustainability, Microsoft recently announced its commitment to be carbon negative by 2030. In response, several initiatives have sprung up all around the company, all in an effort to make Microsoft more sustainable.
And the statement from Microsoft to say, we're going to do this, suddenly becomes an opportunity. Okay, how do we, as a team, as an individual, as an organization, how do we contribute to the Microsoft goal?
When developers spin up a new Azure system, there's a cost associated with the size of the virtual machines, or VMs, and storage. Jonathan Bradshaw, a product owner on the supply chain team within core services engineering and operations, knows that a design decision when building an Azure system can increase the company's carbon footprint during the lifetime of a project. So, what's one way to lower the company's carbon footprint? Reduce cloud usage. Hi everyone, my name is Alina Ansari, and I'm a reporter for Core Services Engineering and Operations, the engineering organization at Microsoft that builds and delivers the products, processes, and services that our company runs on. Paul Rojas, a program manager on the Azure Optimization team at Microsoft, had already been working with teams to develop recommendations for optimizing their Azure usage to increase their cost savings. Now the goal is to shift the conversation to quantify Azure usage in terms of carbon footprint, which measures the amount of greenhouse gases emitted during a project. To support this mission, Paul is developing a dashboard that helps employees track the environmental impact of their Azure virtual machine usage. Powered by Microsoft Power BI and Microsoft Azure Data Explorer, this dashboard can mobilize employees to take action by optimizing their design system or reducing the size of their VMs if there's underutilized storage.
It's really just taking the data that we have and bringing it to the top so customers and employees can make educated decisions on how do I want to use this service and is there a better service that I can accomplish my needs with that has a smaller carbon footprint.
It addresses the immediate, how much carbon are you emitting? What is your impact on the environment? They can go, oh, okay, that's my service. I built that service and that's its carbon impact. Is there something I can do about that?
While Microsoft is working hard to be carbon neutral, there's still more work to be done. Sustainability isn't a goal that can be set and forgotten about. It's a constantly moving target with objectives and tactics that need to keep adapting and innovating. So no matter where you are on your sustainability journey, it's always a great time to start learning more. Ask questions. Get in touch with the people you're purchasing equipment from, or ask the suppliers further up the supply chain about their carbon footprint.
So if you knew how many laptops you had, or how many desktops or how many servers were in your data center, then you should be able to translate that into your own type of metrics.
So regardless of where your organization is with sustainability, Paul encourages you to be a vocal advocate.
You just have to be that one voice that says, no, this is something that we envision that in the next 5 years is going to pick up and our customers are going to be aware of it. It's going to have its bumps, and part of it is the journey and the learning along the way to get to where we say this is the mountain I want to climb.
To learn more about how Core Services Engineering and Operations is contributing to Microsoft sustainability goals, check out Microsoft.com/IT Showcase.